So feel free to share the stream. I'm going to get a tweet out when I get a chance. Someone messed with the volume, and I'm not very happy about that. But anyways, yeah, we're in top 8 now. Woo! We've had a pretty crazy tournament. Some pretty nice upsets, too. Some pretty close, almost upsets, but not quite. We almost had Gore. Well, we had Gore taking over Cinnaboo, first of all. Yeah. That was really hype, and he's made it all the way to top 8 loser side after losing to Dath in quarters.
He actually, it was game 3 last hit against P-Town.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I don't know what Chaco and DJ Jack's set count was or like what the games were like, but
yeah, I'm not
the fact
sure.
that DJ Jack won is an upset. Probably
it is an upset. I mean, like he's a great player, but he doesn't come out much, so he doesn't have any results. Whereas Chaco has been on the grind.
Yeah, but Chaco does know the Wario matchup really well. So.
Oh, absolutely.
So it definitely gets up to DJ Jack.
DJ Jack, Wario maybe stronger than Snorlax Wario, though? How do you feel about that?
I mean,
one of them's in top 8 right now.
Yeah, I'm the first guy to say that people can be better with a character and still like not get this like as good of a result. But, but I'm pretty sure Gnorly is like, if you do better with the character, you're better with
that's,
the character.
Yeah, that's a very Snorly type logic. But
so, I don't know. Maybe he would say it. But who knows? I mean, who knows?
Either way, yeah, good stuff to both of these players making it to top 8. The other side of the bracket is going to be Diabeo, who beat Dan Strife. He hasn't beaten Dan Strife in a really long time. So good stuff
to
him.
Yeah, he actually knocked
and
out Cinnaboo.
He also knocked out
Cinnaboo. That was also game 3 last hit.
Nice.
Like last hit.
So Diabeo playing on fire, which he'll need to because he's going to fight the winner of Sabrek and Mr. Riddle after this match. Right. That was a sick up smash at ledge from Gore.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. Yeah. Ness's smash attacks.
Yeah, really. It's actually stupid.
Will they get past? No double jump? Oh, no, he landed.
But yeah, both players are evening up stock, 0-0 piece, now both at around 30.
Yeah. Gore trying to take advantage of catching DJ Jack's double jump, but it's so hard to take advantage of Wario when he's directly above you. Because his air dodge and just like aerial mobility in general are so good at just like weaving around your attacks. Either way, super even game, and when I say even, I mean even stocks and percent, but DJ Jack has a full off.
He does. But Ness has that kill power. Like, if Ness really needs to delete a stock, just get up attack that. If Ness really needs to delete a stock, he can, you know?
Yeah, I mean,
Ness isn't one of those characters where a lot of characters, like, against Wario, you get him to, like, 140, 150, your kill confirms don't work anymore, and you're sweating because he's got full waft and you're at 50, right?
But we just saw Raw hit at 125 mid-stage.
Yeah, exactly. So Ness kind of okay with that lifestyle.
Good back air from DJ Jack. I'm surprised he doesn't push harder off stage, but I understand against Ness it's a little harder because of how good his air dodge is. You don't want to commit. No double jump, no bike probably.
Ooh. Yeah, bike's on stage. Oh, I thought it was on stage.
No, it had broken, but I thought it was too close. Oh, good.
Oh, okay.
Good forward tilt. Kind of not the greatest air dodge from Gore. Trying to grab ledge, going a little high. And 11% to 87, dead even. And DJ Jack dancing around Gore's shield. If he had actually been hitting the shield, it would have been a lot scarier for Gore. But just barely whiffing the nair and falling up air. Right, and this is up tilt slash falling up air slash second hit of nair fish time. Or maybe just raw waft?
Yeah. Ooh.
Went for a raw waft, missed, and that's probably it.
That's gonna
it's not it, hard, it but it's like we're back at that percent for DJ Jack where
Ness
like
can get gimped.
Yeah, but we're also at like that raw hit
back
kill
air
percent,
back throw. There it is. Yeah. Yep. And you kind of have to see that coming when, you know, Ness does the down B stall. Like what do you think they're going to do out of it? Do you leave?
Yeah,
go away.
But it's also one of those things where you're trying to like meet Ness. You're trying to like keep him above you. So I understand how he gets hit, but
Yeah, absolutely.
It's also one of those things where, like, where you miss.
It's a good tech. That's why it works
most
of the time.
It's like when you miss, you're like, oh no.
Yeah.
You're like, oh, God. I didn't see where they were going. Maybe running it back?
I honestly never see where they're going.
Yeah. That's because it's the first thing that happens here, running it back. That's, like, the least important thing to me for some reason. All right. Running it back. I understand. Like, if you have a close game one and you like the stage, like, don't be afraid to run it back even if you lose. Yeah, but it's one of those things when you're playing Wario and you miss full waft when you're losing last stock, you're like, okay, that's how I was going to win. Now I just need to, like, really hope I don't get touched. Yeah, it's kind of rough. Ooh, missed tech from Gore and DJ Jack following up with the forward smash, almost killing. Good back air. Good chase also from DJ Jack, trying to catch him with the down air off stage. Not quite getting it, though. And not the greatest ledge trapping for DJ Jack, but, like, technically, Gore hasn't really had a chance to play until right now. Again, solid back air.
That always scares me.
I've been watching
Shaky do that since Brawl.
Yeah.
And it's I see that and I'm just like, he's going to die. All right, so that's something that I've been seeing Gore do a lot in both his winner sets and this set, is he'll go for like that smash attack at ledge, which is really good, but even when his opponent has already escaped it and it's like pretty he just keeps charging it. Like, no, just let it go and try and get out of there. There's no reason to keep charging it when he's like not near you anymore, you know?
Yeah.
People aren't just going to run into that.
I mean,
good people aren't going to run into that.
At this point,
we're in top 8 now,
It's not impossible. Oh, well.
See, that one was fine.
Yeah, okay, that's right. He was still bummed. Yeah. All right, but Gore in a bad position and with full waft about to be on deck.
Nice bounce. Oh!
Okay,
doesn't
still
get
good. Still, he only has an air dodge. Okay, he definitely should have just committed to run off down air, and if he got hit, then Gore still might have not made it back.
He could have actually wafted the ledge.
Yeah, I know, but you don't want to like burn waft for that. That should
have
been.
Why not get stock lead? I think that would have been great. He was only at 46 at the time.
It's one of those things where like you want to hold on to full waft if they're already close to clip percent.
Just get up attack that. Get up attack, Danny. Push the A button. Wow. Danny, just push the A button. He doesn't know.
I don't know if he's used that move in this game. And I don't mean like in the set. I mean literally. I don't know if like DJ Jack has since buying Smash Ultimate has tried get up attack because of how bad it was in Smash 4.
That's fair. Ooh, that was nice though, getting around the up smash.
Yeah, but he took a lot of unnecessary percent. He probably could have sealed the stock at around like 40 or 50, and instead, Gore coming right back and taking a stock, evening it up, and this could be last stock of DJ Jack's tournament. Good read on the bite. That's the other thing. When you have waft, it's so much easier to get grabs, and unfortunately, Wario's grabs aren't quite as good in this game, but bite is still really good.
Did I do that right? Did Gore win game 1?
Yeah, he got the back air.
Yeah, you're right.
DJ Jack missed. Oh, that should be it.
Oh, he jumped to the side.
Yeah. Well, okay.
He's still got a pretty nice. Yeah, he still has a lead. Yeah.
So, if you have the lead and you miss waft, you're not.
Then you're done.
Worried about it.
Or sorry.
But
if you don't have the
losing
lead,
by a lot and you miss waft, you're like, oh god. F tilt.
Punish it. Hard. Okay. Chill. That's cool. Back air. Oh, he just missed. That would have killed it too.
Good nair out of shield. That Nair, the Nair buffs are, like, so big. Like, you can actually use the move.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Not quite well. Ooh, that was close.
Oh, really bad spot. Double jump up here. I'm surprised Gordon chased him a little harder. But I guess it's hard for Ness.
Get up attack. Yeah, let's go. He's learning.
He was just saving it for a rainy day.
Right.
He wanted Gordon to have that false sense of security.
Yeah.
Oh, that should be it. Yeah.
The untackable and everything. Wow.
Yeah. How do you feel about that mechanic?
Stupid. Get rid of it immediately.
Yeah, I kind of agree.
Anything that forces, like... Yeah, anything with no counterplay is just dumb, in my opinion.
Anything with no counterplay.
Like, you can make it difficult to tech at high percent. Make it, like, a very small frame window.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind if
I'd be okay with that.
That'd be kind of cool if they made it, like, a super tight frame window, the higher percent.
Exactly. The higher the percent, the harder it was tech. That's fine. But don't, like, just not let me able to tech at all. I don't care if I'm at 400%.
Yeah.
If I push it at the right time, it's a one frame window. if I push it at the right time, I deserve to live, okay?
Right.
That's my opinion on the matter, but...
I agree. Yeah, it kind of sucks when you're like that. He was at like 160. It's like, yeah, I get that like...
Yeah.
If you got hit the other way, you'd die.
Yeah, exactly.
But it's like, if I got hit across stage, I probably wouldn't have died, so why can't I take it?
Yeah, that's a good point. It's true. Very true. So, but anyways, we're going to Yoshi's Island for game number 3. And this was Gore's counterpick. Interesting. I don't love it for
Wario. And I think that's probably the main reason why is that little lip probably makes charging smash attacks on ledge a lot scarier.
Oh, I'm so sad for Gore.
That's
he
really
earned
rough.
That, and he died.
Yeah, probably taking a deep breath there.
Yep.
Hanging on that Halo platform a little longer than normal.
I should probably get the player cam on now since we're in top 8 and I can more easily manage things.
Getting
I thought he was going for a...
Getting, like, Nair combos on the stage is probably a little bit harder as Wario.
Yeah.
like getting the second hit of Nidalee just because of the slants.
Yep. As opposed to Ness, like the slants, I feel like don't. Hey, he's doing it now. Nice. The slants don't really mess up Ness in terms of. You
right.
Know,
if anything, like PK firing stuff. From ledge is probably a little easier to, like, if you're standing with your back towards the blast zone at ledge, PK fire might still go over the rest of the stage and like it catches people more easily. I don't know. Possible reasons for counterpicking, but. Looking pretty
like,
good for you.
He's got the wall too to like if he can kind of use the wall to you're dead
to recover a little bit. Yeah. Even though Ness is really good call on the full hop. That's the thing. You have to like kind of like weigh the cons of each defensive option you have after you kill a player. Like against Wario, like I was saying before, they don't have great grabs.
Yeah.
Like. They're good at edge guarding, so it is kind of like risky to get grabbed by ledge. But like at the same time, like I'd rather get grabbed at ledge than
put off
full hop and like
jump.
Above him. Yeah, it's like a little.
What happens?
He can still make it back.
There's that bounce. Yep.
Oh.
What he just fell off stage.
Yeah, he just air dodged.
I think
off
he
stage.
Wanted to go to the ledge and shields, and he accidentally got